My wife has a problem. Her desk no longer fits everything that she needs to put on it. Primarily three monitors, but also stuff like cups, mugs, food, keyboard, mouse, whatever. So today we're gonna be building a simple desk riser out of some lumber that I got from Home Depot. Just enough to rise her monitors a little bit so she has stuff under there for everything else she needs to put on her desk, including her speaker and any kind of decorations or storage things she needs under there. For starters, I'm gonna take a look at some desk risers online, which actually inspired this project because of the outrageous price of some of these risers. And instead, I'm just gonna sketch out a basic structure of what I want this to look like. All right, now that I got my plan sketched out, I'm gonna get some wood. All right. One of the nice things about Home Depot is that when you're getting your lumber, they'll typically do a couple cuts for free. This isn't perfectly level wood, but for our purposes, it should be fine. I also picked up some metal corner braces complete with their screws and some nice dark walnut wood stain. I haven't used this before, but we're gonna see how it looks. So this amount of wood was actually two long boards, and it was $7 a piece for a total of $14 of lumber. It's not the absolute best wood in the world. It has some defects, but it'll accomplish what we want. I don't have a planer yet, so I'm unfortunately not able to level this out perfectly, but for this build, this will do. So we don't need to cut any of this. What we do need to cut is five legs out of this. So we're just gonna cut these like this. We're gonna be left over with some lumber. Probably need one of these boards. So I want each one of these legs to be 4.5 inches tall. So I'm gonna go ahead and figure out how to set up my fence here so that each cut will be 4.5 inches. And then we're gonna go down, cut five of these legs. Coming at this with basically no knowledge of how table saws work other than the obvious intuition, my initial idea was that I was going to line this up, measure, and then cut, and then push this through every time. After a little bit of research, I very quickly realized that is a bad idea. This kind of cut is called a cross cut. And this, your fence, should not be used to make cross cuts because of kickback. Kickback is when the board is not perfectly straight going through the blade. So the teeth of the blade catch it and shoot it back, and you can easily hurt yourself. So instead, what you're going to use is your miter gauge. This is an attachment that comes with your table saw, and it slots in to grooves on the table. Then you can put your board up against it and make your cross cuts safely. However, I also discovered that it's typically a good idea to create your own wooden fence, and there are marks on the miter gauge where you can screw it in so that you have a solid, basically cross cut fence to push whatever piece of wood through. That will protect against kickback and make sure that you have a perfect good cut every single time. So this is the piece of wood that I'm gonna be using for the legs. But now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a lengthwise cut, and I'm gonna cut this about in half, and I'm going to use it as my miter fence, which I'll be screwing onto my miter gauge. Not me also deducing that my fence was on backwards this entire time. Oh, yes. Let's go. All right, that's the first thing that I have cut on this new table saw. It did a really good job collecting the sawdust. I don't know if you can see that, but like all the sawdust is in there. I'm not gonna lie to you, I was pretty nervous feeding that through there. Just because I've never done it before, and all of the videos that I just watched were warning me about kickback. However, that worked great. That is a perfect cut. There was no hint of kickback. So first things first, I'm gonna screw this in to my miter gauge here, making sure that it goes a little bit past the blade so that then I can use that to push through all the way when I'm getting my cuts. Okay, so now I have the miter fence set up that I'm gonna use to push my board through to make my cross cuts to cut five legs. So we've run into our first problem, and that is that this guard is keeping my miter fence from going through to make the cut. So I'm gonna have to take it off and just rely on the riving knife to stop kickback. Now you can see that I just have this on, so that's gonna allow us to put the miter gauge in here and make our cut all the way through our miter fence. All right, so now we can see that when I go to use this to push this through for the cross cuts, it's gonna go through every time. If you look closely here, you can see that I know exactly where it's gonna cut my board. So then I can actually move my fence and it's gonna line up perfectly. And then I'm gonna lock it there. Now every single time I slide this through and I make another cut, it's gonna be the exact same distance when I push it through. So now we're gonna go ahead and make those cuts. Here's our first cut. Looks pretty good. Now we're gonna go ahead and cut out the rest of the feet. Now we have our five legs. This is gonna go like this. It doesn't really matter that some of them have some deformities like here, because they are all perfectly the same exact height. So this desk riser is gonna be nice and level. All the wood pieces are cut. I really wanna see how it's gonna look once it's all screwed together. So I'm just gonna assemble it dry on the workbench here, but first I have to clear it. All right, that should do. So here I have my legs. Go 1, 2, 3, 4, and then this one sort of in the middle back. And then we're gonna take our two boards, we'll sit across. So I can tell immediately that there are a few problems. For starters, even though each one of these feet is exactly 4.5 inches tall, due to the bend in these boards, because they're not perfectly straight, this middle foot is not seated very nicely. However, I don't think that's gonna be a big problem. So in the event that it does nothing, this is still very solid and it would take a lot of weight to cause any kind of bending. Next step is gonna be decide how I want these two boards to sit. These are just some angle brackets that I have here, and they came with their own screws, which is kind of nice because it's gonna match the hardware. My wife picked black, and I think that's the right call because it'll look really good once it's stained. Okay, so I think now that I've laid all the hardware out and we've seen how everything's gonna look, I'm gonna mark which boards are which feet go where, and I'm gonna take this outside and I'm gonna stain it to prepare it for final assembly. Pro tip for next time, something we've learned, is rubber gloves. I was just wearing normal work gloves without fingers on the tops. And as you can see, I look like an evenly stained deck.
You look like an evenly stained deck.
That being said, I'm really pleased with how the stain looks. We're gonna wait an hour, flip them over, finish the stain, and then we're gonna get them back downstairs to put some hardware on them and finish this up. All right, that looks pretty good to me. We're gonna give this another hour to dry, and then we're gonna take it all back downstairs to put it together and see how it fits. So we got the wood back now that it's stained. I'm pretty happy with the stain. There's a couple spots where there's a chip or two here or just a little bit of a miss. It's still just the tiniest bit damp. It's not wet, but I didn't do any sanding on the wood. It says to, you know, sand it down before applying the stain, but for something this simple, I didn't feel like that was super necessary. There's only gonna be one piece in the middle here that's connecting the two of them, but I don't think that's a big deal. Honestly, they could probably be freestanding. This is currently the top, so I'm gonna flip it over and then get to setting up the legs. All right, now I'm just gonna drill in the hardware. I'm not gonna be super precise about this because it doesn't matter, but it does matter that the hardware is as tight as can be. I'm gonna measure to make sure I get the exact center for this piece right here. So I can already tell from here that there are some issues with how level this is. Even though these are all the correct size, because this thing wasn't, you know, planed, it's got some wobble to it. And obviously it's only joined these two together in the middle. But for that being said, let's flip it over. There it is. It's far from perfect. It has some quirks. It's pretty solid though. I'm pretty happy with the joinery. It is decently level and it should meet the needs my wife has for it on her desk to create some more space and to get her monitors higher so she has better posture and can work better. But it's one thing to see it here. Let's go take a look and see how it looks in my wife's office.